This is the story of what is called the Sad Night. Keep in mind it was sad for the Spanish, not so much for the Aztecs. After being in the city for a while, Cortes left to go deal with some soldiers who had been sent to arrest him for not following the governor's orders. Cortes bribed the men and they joined up with him instead. While he was gone, the Aztecs had a religious festival in the city. There was all kinds of dancing and stuff, and the Spanish soldiers were a little weirded out by it all. The small Spanish group was told by some people that the Aztecs were going to eat their hearts during the festival. So, they freaked out and locked the doors to the palace. They then killed every Aztec inside. The Spanish called it self-defense, the Aztecs called it murder. When the Aztec people outside the temple heard what happened, they prepared their warriors for battle. Cortes came back and noted that the city was eerily silent. His men told him what had happened, and Cortes was angry and scared. The Aztec people were very angry and gathered around the temple. Cortes got Montezuma and told him to quiet the people down. He took him to the top of the temple to speak to them. He told them to stop the fighting, but the people no longer wanted to listen to him. A rock was thrown from the crowd that hit Montezuma in the head. We don't know if the Aztecs were trying to hit him or Cortes, but he was hit anyway. Montezuma fell to the ground and died. Cortes realized it wasn't safe and ran back into the temple to hide. While in the temple, he came up with a plan to escape the city. The Spanish put cloth on their horses' feet and snuck away in the middle of the night. They got near the edge of the city and then...
it was time to leave. Cortes reluctantly ordered a plan to escape the city, and the Spanish began to load up pack animals and stuff their armor with gold. By night, they set out with a portable bridge and spare timber to cross the canals. With the horses' hooves muffled, they tried to leave undetected. They crossed one canal, then another, then two more. The way seemed open to the safety of the lake shore, where their horses and guns would be an advantage, when a woman drawing water saw them moving. She cried out a warning, and soon the war drums were sounding from the city's highest pyramids. The Spanish ran for the shore, while the Mexicans scrambled into their canoes and began attacking. The old Mexican ways of war were set aside, and instead of striking to wound, they struck to kill. Two canals stood between the Spaniards and safety. The first few Spaniards made it across, and Cortes turned to help the Holy Company fight its way across the causeway. One canal was filled with Spanish and Tlaxcalan dead. Much of the Holy Company and their Tlaxcalan allies were left behind to be taken prisoner by the Mexica and made ready to be sacrificed to the gods and eaten by their captors. That sad night, La Noche Triste, was the first great defeat for Europeans in the New World.
A massive battle broke out, and the Spanish tried to run for their lives. Some were knocked into the lake where their heavy armor caused them to drown. Many Spanish soldiers died, but Cortes escaped. Here's the notes for the story I just told. To make it simple, while Cortes was away, the Spanish soldiers slaughtered many unarmed Aztecs during a religious ceremony. The Aztecs fought back in revenge. Ultimately, a large battle broke out, and the Spanish lost a fight for the first time in Latin America. Cortes lived though, and the sad night was not the end.
But the fleeing Spaniards left behind another enemy. An Aztec survivor, remember.
At about the time that the Spaniards had fled from the city, there came a great sickness, a pestilence, the smallpox. It spread over the people with great destruction of men. It caused great misery. The brave Mexica warriors were indeed weakened by it.
Even the new emperor died of the disease.
It was after all this had happened that the Spaniards came back.
Cortes and his men had healed their wounds and rebuilt their army. New alliances were made. The Spaniards and 75,000 Tlaxcalan and allied Indian soldiers set siege to Tenochtitlan. The entire population rose to defend their city. Aztec witnesses would remember the struggle.
Fighting continued. Both sides took captives. On both sides, there were deaths. Great became the suffering of the common folk. There was hunger. Many died of famine. There was no more good, pure water to drink. Many died of it. The people ate anything. Lizards, barn swallows, corn leaves, salt grass. Never had such suffering been seen. The enemy pressed about us like a wall. They herded us. The brave warriors were still hopelessly resisting.
After 2.5 long months, the Spaniards, with their overwhelming numbers, brought Tenochtitlan to its knees.
Finally, the battle just quietly ended. Silence reigned. Nothing happened. All was quiet and nothing more took place. Night fell, and the next day nothing happened either. No one spoke aloud. The people were crushed.
Great was the stench of the dead. Your grandfathers died, and with them died the son of the king and his brothers and kinsmen. So it was that we became orphans, O my sons. So we became when we were young. All of us were thus. We were born to die.
Tenochtitlan was leveled. The magnificent gardens, the marvel of their world, were destroyed. The rivers and canals that so amazed the Spaniards were filled in. Then Cortez set fire to the aviaries. Thousands of birds, vermilion flycatchers, iridescent hummingbirds, scarlet tanagers, green and blue macaws. The beauty that was Mexico was turned to ashes.
Some say the Mexica came to an end. It's gone, finished. We're still here. We, the people who ignorant outsiders insult by calling us Indians, we are here. This culture was not finished off. The culture is gone as an empire, as a social, political, religious structure. But what remains is what the people have. We weren't finished off.
Proudly stands the city of Mexico, Tenochtitlan. Here no one fears to die in war. Keep this in mind, O princes. Who could attack Tenochtitlan? Who could shake the foundations of heaven?
Cortez was disgraced by the loss of the Sad Knight. He came back with revenge on his mind and a plan to wipe out the Aztecs. Turns out, he didn't have to do much. The diseases he had introduced to the Aztecs, smallpox specifically, decimated the population. When Cortez returned, he found few Aztecs remaining. Those that were left fought back, but Cortez, with his advanced technology, was able to conquer them once and for all. That is all for the Aztec Notes. Next time we'll look at another Latin American culture that was ultimately conquered by the Spanish. Bye bye.